Okay, good day, everybody. We're just going to give it a little bit more time for people to join the meeting. We've got well over 100 people join us today, so we will just give it a little bit more time. So if you can just be patient, I know some of you. Okay, lovely. Some of you can hear us now, so that's great. Okay, hopefully you can all hear me now. Thank you for joining on time, and welcome to our presentation about applied generals. My name is Colin Ilsley, and I'm one of the heads of learning at Worthing College. And this morning I'm going to be joined by Sam Cosham, who's subject leader for health and social care and law. So we're going to be going through this presentation with you. There are a number of slides for you to read and obviously listen to us at the same time. Feel free to use the chat button to ask any questions, and some of those might get answered as we go along. But if they don't, we'll try and answer them at the end. Okay. So, Megan, if you can just move us along. So, first of all, welcome to both Worthing College potential students and also from Haywards Heath as well. It's great that you're all here this morning. The weather's not great, so obviously it's a good time to be inside listening to us. So, this talk is all about applied general qualifications. Okay, so the first thing is, so what is an applied general qualification? You need to consider an applied general qualification as any course that's not an A-level. Okay, so A-levels are assessed at the end of 2 years, okay, where you have what we call terminal exams at the end of two years. So the applied generals are assessed differently. Okay, and the different ways that they're assessed include things like coursework, exams, controlled assessments, practicals. So quite different to the A levels that you may be more familiar with. Okay, and the applied generals come with different titles. So on the screen, you'll see some of the different applied generals that we offer. We've got BTECs, we've got CAMTECs, City and Guilds, WJEC, that's the Welsh Board, the IBF, which is Institute of Banking and Finance, and then RSL, which is Rock School. Okay, so we have a different set of applied generals with different names, okay? But realistically, those titles that you might come across are just to do with the exam board. So just like GCSE, where you might have had different exam boards, those labels that you see in front of you are very much to do with just the different exam boards. But they are all the same, okay? They're the same levels, and they are all equivalent to A-levels. They're just assessed in a different way. Okay, next slide, please, Megan. So, what are your options when it comes to applied generals? Now, at Worthing, we have 17 different types of applied generals. For those of you at Haywards Heath, there's slightly less this year. But there is a whole variety of different options. And you'll see that there are some examples down there. So you've got a business CAMTEC, Okay, and that's a certificate and leading on to the extended certificate in the second year. You've got an applied science Camtec, which is an extended certificate, leads on to a diploma in the second year. Sport, which is a foundation diploma and leads on to an extended diploma in the second year. And then the criminology, which is a certificate in the first year and a diploma in the second year. So those are just some examples that are offered at both campuses. But as I said, there's a whole host of them that are applied generals. But you'll see that the courses have different names, as in certificate, extended certificate. And those are important because those dictate the size of the qualification. Okay, and Sam will explain a little bit more about that on the next slide.
Thanks, Colin. So both colleges offer, as Colin's already said, a wide range of applied general courses. The easiest comparison for us to explain the different sizes to you is to compare them to A-levels, because most of us are familiar with the structure for these. The level three certificate. So you can see on here that we've mentioned certificate and extended certificate. The certificate is a complete qualification. It's taken commonly over 1 year, and then it's worth the equivalent to half of an A-level or an AS in old money. So it's worth half of an A-level. Commonly that then leads to a second year of study, which gives you this full 2 years, which means the extended certificate. That is then the equivalent to one A-level. There's a foundation diploma that can be taken again as a 1 year course, and it has the equivalency to 1.5 A-levels. But again, commonly that is actually a 2 year course of study, which leads to the extended diploma, which is worth three A-levels. Finally, we've got the level three diploma, which kind of sits in the middle, and that is worth the equivalent to two A-levels. So you can see that they do have a direct comparison across the different types of qualification. Megan, can we have the next slide, please? Thank you. Now, in terms of how they're assessed, Colin's already touched on how they're different to A-levels. So with an A-level, you study for 2 years, and you are assessed at the end of that two-year period. Nearly all of the applied generals are a real mix of coursework and external assessment. So there are still some elements of external assessment in most of the courses. But this means that there's a wide range of skills that are tested, and they don't simply rely on your ability to retain large chunks of information across a two-year period. Each qualification is broken down into units, and each unit is a different length, and therefore a different value. And each of the units can be achieved to either pass, merit, or distinction level, with distinction being the highest. Now, these are cumulative. So what that means is that if you're going to achieve the pass, you need to achieve all of the pass criteria. If you're going to achieve a merit, you need to achieve all of the pass and the merit. And as there's a pattern here, in order to achieve the distinction, you need to have achieved all of the pass, merit, and distinction. Depending upon the size of the units, and not all units are the same size, they carry a variety of different points, and those points are then accrued to achieve an overall grade at the end of the first year, and then again at the end of the second year. We adopt a wide range of methods for capturing this knowledge, in addition to the external assessment, and that's quite often a portfolio of work, and that can be made up of written work, presentations, work experience, and then for other subject-specific tasks according to the subject that you're studying. The expectation is that each student will spend as much time outside of the classroom on their independent study as they do inside the classroom. So if you're taking three subjects, which is the most common, then you'd have 12 hours contact time inside the classroom, and the expectation is that you would replicate that in terms of independent study outside of the classroom. You might find you're working on coursework, or if it's an externally assessed unit, you'll be given what we call an ISP, which is an independent study pack, and your time will be spent working on that. Can we have the next slide, Megan? As I started off by saying, the applied generals do test a wide range of skills. It does include, but is not limited to, knowledge retention. So again, it's not about remembering vast swathes of information, although there is, of course, an element of that. One of the most important skills that you are going to refine studying these courses is that of deadline management. It's really crucial, life skill as well, to be able to meet deadlines. We all ensure that our deadlines are clearly communicated, they are prominently displayed in classrooms, and they have to be met. That's a requirement of the boards. If we assume that deadline is met, then you have a chance to resubmit any work for improvement if it's necessary. So you get one chance to take that work back with some feedback, to make some improvements and to give it back to be reassessed. You get 10 days to do that. The problem comes if you didn't meet the original deadline, then sometimes that opportunity is actually not available to you anymore. So it's just absolutely crucial that deadlines are met. So you need to get really good at time management really quickly. If you've resubmitted the work and it doesn't meet the minimum pass, then that piece of work is deemed to have failed. However, there is a further opportunity later on down the line to retake one piece of work at the end of the year. So all is not lost by any stretch. All level three applied generals that have external assessments, so that is most of them, have two sittings. They have one in January and then they have a further one either in May or June of the same year. So that can be used again to resit the January paper to make any improvements if you need or want to do so. Level two applied general qualifications are arranged on demand. I'm going to hand you back to Colin.
Okay, so whatever qualification that you take, you want to be successful at it. So the applied generals are excellent at providing progression opportunities to employment, apprenticeships, and higher education. So on the screen there are three bits of information to support the value of applied generals. So I'll just give you 30 seconds to just have a read of those. So you can see from reading those that employers really value applied generals, often because they have a vocational element to it, which means a practical element up to it. So you link your theory to practice, and many of them will have work experience embedded, particularly the bigger qualifications. So therefore they are attractive to employers. They obviously then, that links onto apprenticeships as well, where much of the apprenticeship is spent in the workplace, and also higher education. So the opportunity to progress to university is very important because applied generals give you lots of chances to choose university courses. So Megan, can you go to the next slide, please? Okay, and this is why. So this is the UCAS point system. So for those of you interested in going to university, this is how the points for vocational courses, and in this case, it's highlighted a BTEC, compare with the points that you'll get for an A-level. So you'll see that an A-star at A-level, which is obviously really difficult to achieve, it's a real challenge. But if you were to get a distinction star at a applied general, you get the same UCAS points. Okay, so those UCAS points are really important. Okay, so can you go to the next slide, please, Megan? And here's two examples why. So these are just random types of courses. Okay, unless you're applying for courses such as medicine, veterinary, dentistry, where universities will ask for specific A levels. Okay, many universities now just ask for points. Okay, so this is where the points that you gain from your applied generals really help you. So you've got two examples there, one from sport coaching at University of Winchester, one from University of Derby. So they are looking for a range of points, which are highlighted on there. Okay, so it's about how you achieve those points. It's not asking you for particular A levels. It's saying that you can use applied generals or you can use A levels, and they all contribute to getting those points. So this is how you're going to see most universities now for majority of their courses. So that's why maximizing your points at UCAS is really important. Okay, so it's making the right choices about whether or not you do A level or whether you do an applied general, it's trying to consider how you're going to be most successful, and if you're going to university, how you might gain as many points as possible. Okay, so hopefully in the 15 minutes we've spent talking to you, you're a little bit clearer about what an applied general is, okay, how they come in different sizes, how they're assessed, and how they can support progression. Okay, so can we go to the next slide, Megan? Okay, so there are more resources that are on the college website, okay, not only for this event, but also if you're looking at the individual course descriptions, you can find information about that as well. So the websites for both Haywards Heath and Worthing are really important forms of getting further information. If you go to the next slide, Megan. Okay, so all this information will be uploaded to the website. Okay, this is being recorded so that you'll have an opportunity to revisit it if you need to. One of the things I wanted to pick up on from one of the questions that was asked was about do you need to do or can you do all applied generals? There is a real flexibility of approach to the courses. So some of the applied generals are 3 A-level equivalents, and therefore that's all you would do, because you need to do 3 A-level equivalents. But some are 2 A-level equivalents and some are 1. Okay. You can mix and match A-levels. You can take obviously all A-levels, you can take all applied generals, or you can mix and match. And that's one of the important things about the flexibility of our curriculum. Okay, we're coming to the end. All right, I know some of you have posted questions and we've tried to answer them as we go along. If there are any further questions, keep on posting them. And what we'll do is that we'll look to answer them and get them on the website. But as we're coming towards the end, okay, we will say thank you very much for your time, and we will get back to you, okay, with those answers as soon as possible. Have a great day, and hope you enjoy the rest of the sessions. Okay, thank you. Goodbye.